PHP backdoors. As I mentioned, this is just a really simple way for an attacker to bypass any potential controls you might have in place. Think about it as your house. You have a house, you lock your doors, you lock your windows, but you leave your back door open, right? Maybe your dog goes in and out, et cetera. So the attacker comes in, he walks around your house, he walks in the back door, boom, he's in your house. It's exactly the same thing. So attacker comes in, just because you see their payload, maybe they dropped SEO spam, or maybe they dropped some malware dropper, or they did some other nefarious activity like crypto jacking, it doesn't mean that they've lost value in your environment. So what they do is they take a little file and they put it in the back door. What that allows them to do is it says, hey, I no longer have to go to your admin. I no longer have to go to your WP admin. I don't have to go to any control that you might have in place that you're trying to drive funnel. I'll just go directly to pressbox.com/backdoor.php and I'll bypass all his controls and I'll log right into his environment because it'll give me all the permissions I need. What's interesting is in 68%, right, of all the cases we looked at, we always found backdoors. And so just cleaning what you see is not enough. On the malware distribution side, we saw a really interesting spike. And I was kind of talking to the threat team this morning, like, hey, why do we think this is happening? It wasn't a really clear answer. But what we can say is we're seeing a lot of like payment skimmers, right? People are trying to strip information around credit cards, you know, replacing things, putting malware in the forms to capture entries and things like that, which would explain a lot if you look at the growth of online commerce. We did see a really healthy growth in malware. It actually bumped SEO spam to the third spot. It used to be in the second spot. SEO spam, or what I would call search engine poisoning attacks, right, is exactly as the name implies, right? So as you see on the image here on the right, an attacker is abusing a website and their SEO to promote whatever they're looking for. It's traditionally been known for pharma hacks, which is still very prevalent today, but we also see it in things like SEO. I mean, we saw an SEO spam attack targeting student loans or essay writing. So like, if you want to write an essay, go find here. And what they're doing is they leverage all these other brands. They may have marginal SEO positioning, but it just gives them an ability to raise their awareness on whatever they're pushing. Why is that so valuable? Well, because it's predominantly impression-based. That was one of the things that the pharma industry identified many years ago, which is they had an impression-based affiliate scheme that says, hey, all I gotta do is somebody to see it, somebody to click on it, and I'm generating money. So with that alone explains this rise that we've seen over the past 3 years of search engine poisoning spam specifically.